Hello friend, this is Supnin and welcome to Learn SAP ABAP. So in this session we are going to see what is a polymorphism in SAP ABAP object oriented programming. Okay, so polymorphism is a concept by which same method name will behave differently in a different class. That is, each method will have its own implementation in a different class but with the same name. Okay, so how can we change implementation in a subclass? Okay, that is with the help of a redefinition. Okay, that means so subclass can redefine an inherited method and change its functionality. Okay? So let's go to the SAP and we will see it practically. And I will request you, if you are the first time on my channel, then please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get notification of my upcoming videos. Okay, so stay tuned till the end and keep watching Learn SAP ABAP.
So today we are going to see the polymorphism. Okay, so as I have already told you, like, polymorphism is a concept by which the same method will behave differently in a different class. That is, each method will have its own implementation in a different class but with the same name. Okay, if you don't understand what I'm talking about, so don't worry, please watch this video till the end. Okay, so you will also come to know how we can use the redefinition. Okay, so let's see what I have done so far. So I have just created a different section, create parent class section. It's a grandparent section, parent class section and child class section. Okay, so we'll execute, we'll show you. So okay, so this is our grandparent class section, this is the parent class section and the child class section. Okay, so what we are going to do is we are going to just print the message in three different sections. Okay, so let's see, in the first section, grandparent section, we will print as a grandparents method executed. The second one we will use a parent class method executed, and the third one we will print as a class child class method executed but with the same method name. Okay, so we are not going to change the method name, we are going to create only one method, but in the inherited class we are going to change the functionality of this method. Okay, so with the same method name we will use three other implementation. Okay, so you will also get so please watch this video till the end, so you will also get the idea how we can achieve this functionality. Okay, we are going to create only one method. Okay, so and we are going to just create the three different implementation for the same method name. Okay, so where method name will be same but we will change the functionality in each class. Okay, so let's see how. Let's go to the SAP. Okay, so we'll create first grand class, class parent, definition. Okay, so we'll end class. Okay, then we'll use a public section. Okay, so as I already shown you in our last video, so how we can create a class in video. Okay, so if you didn't watch the video, so you may click on the link given in the description. Okay, so you may find all the object oriented programs over there. Okay, so public section, here what we will do, we'll create one variable. So let's see, data lv or variable message, say message. Okay, so we'll use it here, type string. Okay, so and here what we will do, we create one method, define one method. Okay, so what will method display. Okay, method display. Okay, so now we have almost created our first method. Okay, so first class, define our plus class. Now we will implement this grand parent class, class grand parents implementation with end class. In this class we will just implement this method. Okay, method empty display. Okay, so message what we will do as a grand parents class method executed. Okay, okay, and we give as a write statement lv message, we'll give it some color. Okay, so that it is 6 intensive field off. Okay, so now we have implemented our first method, so we'll create, let's check an active name. Sorry, we made some mistake. Grandparent. Okay, lv message. Okay, fine. So now what we are going to do is we will create a second class. Okay, as a parent class, inheriting this grand parent class. Okay, so how we can, so let's see, class cl Parent definition inheriting from this class, parent grandparent class, okay, and end class. Fine. So here in the public section, what we will do, we will just use this method only, okay. So see, now the method name is same, okay, but we are going to change the functionality, okay. How we can change the functionality? Using the redefinition statements, okay. Now as you can see, the method name is same, okay, in this child class also. So we will use, okay. So now just implement this kind, okay. So let's copy this implementation. We'll make the changes as per our class. Say parents, parents. Here we'll use a parent class method executor and change the color as a 3. Okay, method display, check and activate. Okay, so now what we are going to do, we will create one more class as a last child class. Okay, so class CN child definition inheriting from the same class, okay, the grandparent class. And here end class, okay. So now here what we will do, we will just do the same thing, okay. Here also we will define a public section, and here also we will use the same method display, but we have to change the functionality, right? So for that we will use as a redefinition, okay. So redefinition, okay. So what does it mean? The subclass can redefine the inherited method and change its functionality, okay. That is the reason we use the redefinition. And here also we will do the same thing again. We will copy the same method, we'll change as a child class, and we'll use again as a child class method executed, okay. We will change the color also as a 5, okay. Check and activate, okay. So now we have almost done with our implementation part, okay. So now as you can see, we have just defined only one method, okay, display, but the same method we are using in the subclass also, parent class subclass also, and child subclass also, okay. The name is the implement, the name of the method is same, but we are just changing the implementation, okay, changing the functionality inside the subclass, okay. So let's now we just need to create the reference, okay. So here what we will do, we will create the reference variable. Now we have to execute our method, correct, okay? For that, what we will just execute. So what we will do, right, data, create object, we'll create a reference variable, object grandparent type, refer to CL. What is our class? Grandparent. This is our class, okay, grandparent. And what we will do, we will create object, okay, in order to call method, okay, create object parent class, and then we'll call method. What is the method? What is our method? It's a display, okay. So in the parent class also we will do the same thing. First we will do, what we will do, we will just create the reference variable. Let's say data, local object, parent type, refer to CL parent class, okay. Then we will create the object, say create object with the name, so object, and here we will call the method, okay. Call method, which method? Inside this parent class display, okay. And in the child class also we will do the same thing, data hello child type, refer to CL child create object, the child call method from child class. What is our method? Same method display, okay. So now as you can see, in our, this is our 3 different section, but in each section, now in each section we have used the same method, okay. So here is a method name also same, here also method name also same, here also method name is same, but we have changed the functionality, okay, inside this subclass, okay. So let's activate and we will execute this method now, okay. So let's execute, okay. So now as you can see, the first section is grandparents class method executed, in the second section we have parent class method executed, and in the third section we have child class method executed, okay. So what we have done here is we have a same method name, okay. So as you can see, we have same method name, but we are in grandparent class, in the parent class, and in the child class also, okay, the same method name, but we have changed the functionality, okay, using the redefinition, okay. So the redefinition is a word keyword. By using this, we will just change the implementation of any inherited method, okay. Debug, execute. So I hope, friend, at least now you know how we can use the redefinition, okay, and how the polymorphism works. What is a polymorphism and redefinition work in SAP ABAP? Okay, so this is a very easy. So whenever you want to change the functionality of any method by using the same name, so you can use the redefinition. Okay, so what is the redefinition? So subclass can redefine an inherited method and change the functionality. Okay, I hope so it's clear for you. So if you have any doubt, then please write me in a comment section below. Okay, so, bye.
If you like this video, then press the like button below. If you have any doubt, then write me in a comment section below. If you want to learn more about ABAP, then visit to my website www.learnsapabap.com. The link is also given in the description. And please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get notification about my next upcoming videos. Okay, so friends, bye. Signing out.